going to be dealing. So anyhow, I shall introduce this. I shall introduce the side of Team Tab. C. Gain? Gane?
Gane.
Playing the winter.
Probably Gane.
Gane playing the Gane. Playing the winter item support and the lit support played by MMSDA. The offlane Timbersaw being played by Iconoa. And the mid tier being by Katza. Region 1, Ursa being played by Scoopy. Why don't you introduce the dire side?
Side already smoked up, I see. We have Duke, Rook, Kane, Razor, Beamos, support Lion.
30 seconds and, Disruptor,
the Dead Slayer on the Luna, D-Pain on the clock.
So the smoke was broken, like the Disruptor smoke
was broken, yes.
Yeah. And they know what's going to be
already devoting on the horn come from.
The other sentry goes over, it's just a bit too late. So Disruptor based one sentry and one ward.
Yes, Templar Assassin able to pick up on the top.
Going to be a pretty interesting mid matchup.
Very interesting. I think there's a pause of the game.
Okay, so this mid lane, Razor is going to be able to link the Templar Assassin and move around even if the Templar Assassin does manage to melt. And going to be able to do pretty okay in the lane as long as he doesn't get a lot of Cyblade harassments done to him. It's going to be pretty okay in the lane.
I think apparently the Razor was complaining about the delay. Let's see. The bottom lane being pushed so far up ahead. Scooby being cogged up already.
See, the cog, using the cog early on effectively, not to cog inside but to actually burn the mana
and he
just cogged him inside doing basically no damage whatsoever. Okay, a little bit of damage, but would have been better off to actually the cogs to push him out and burn a little bit of mana. And like I said, that duel he would have 2-1-2.
Yes, because I think the top would actually give less XP and farm on that Luna.
True, mainly due to the fact that the Lich is going to be using their sacrifice to deny as much creeps as he can, and also in turn use the Frost Blast on the Luna to deal out that harassment. But when it comes to killing potential, though, if they do get a proper initiation on the Lich, they might be able to bring it down with Disruptor and Lion, but they do need a few more levels behind them. The Lion does need his Hex and the Disruptor a level off his Glimpse.
I agree. We see the both the supports being pulling the creep wave onto the creep wave first campsite.
Was it a stack pull? So I'm pretty sure that
I don't think it was a stack
before pulling.
I don't. Yeah. So yes. It's the first minute already.
Right. So the lane is going to get pushed a lot due to the fact that he's not stuck and pull unless he decides to cut this tree and drag the second camp towards the creep wave.
I agree. They had at the more pulling potential, and if he would have stacked, he would have got much more experience. Well, just rather than DM pain enough and more farm on the creep wave putting forward.
True. We have the line break reconnecting back.
Connection.
The game is still paused. I think the tournament after the Reborn coming main source for Dota 2 and after the 6.85 re-correction, I would say. How is that treating you?
I have been experiencing a lot of lags, a lot of bugs, a lot of crashes non-stop. Actually, the amount of Dota that I have played has reduced a lot.
How's the update, Shakira?
Thank God I have a bit enough bandwidth to actually deal with the updates. But other than that, Source 2 has not been treating me that well. Hopefully, they'll be able to fix all these errors by the end of the year.
Let's hope so. Let's hope so. We have
SSCG coming up as well, and that's going to be the first LAN tournament after the Source 2 came out, and it's going to be interesting to see the amount of problems that we run into there as well.
Yes, it's good. I have a lot of planes to be expected from players to the...
Okay, I actually can't hear you a lot. You're breaking up a lot now, of course.
Same goes for you. I'm like, I don't know, is it just me?
So Luna has gone for 1 point in his Luna Blessing as expected, and Timbersaw going for that early reactive armor, going to be able to survive and heal up in the lane. And Lich, basically the first two skills as always, and Tia basically getting a lot of farm on the mid lane, sitting at 6 CS and 7 denies, and the Razor, maybe mainly due to the fact that he was having a bit of delay early on, has basically nothing out of the lane at the moment.
He's actually been back.
Maybe due to the fact that he DC'd from the game, I think that's why he has been pushed back. Pretty sure he was not thinking of going back out of the game.
What do you think on this 1-1 on the... I would say I would rather prefer on the static link and the current being picked up with the TA.
No, but the thing is, the only reason for Razor for picking up the unstable current would be for that movement speed, because the unstable current won't get triggered because the TA not have any point target spells per se, and he basically has no skills that would actually trigger the unstable current, so he won't get purged off. So I guess going for the static link and the plasma field is a better choice. See, if you're going up against heroes like maybe the Obsidian Destroyer or any hero that has actually point out spells, the Tinker, the OD, then going for those levels in Unstamped would be good. But against a tier early on, I think it's better to go for more levels in the Static Link power. And Plasma Field. Yeah, exactly. Make sure to get those Refraction Charges off and out with a plasma.
Yeah, now apparently after the new patch, the refraction charges, I suppose. And we have, the digs being drawn on the map. Apparently, RL is apparently hated so much. We have a reconnected, we have a Razor back.
Okay, thank God for
and,
that.
And is back.
Hey, during the pause, I'm going to go drink some water. This is my second game casting in a row. I really do need some water. Until
ahead,
the Razor reconnects
go
back.
Ahead, go.
Prediction.
The pause being we are the game and I just saw that that Dennis Cook has picked a tango until he just spun. I would have him on the Stout Shield. Standard Stout Shield, I would say. Good use of the cog there.
Okay, so Shaize apparently are having cut loss. That's why your voice is breaking. And mine is actually clear to the Kirazgram. I just checked with some of them whether my voice was breaking up. That's why you're hearing my voice is broken as well. It's due that you're having pack. Try to restart whether it would get fixed. Yeah, restart the router and see whether. Meanwhile, the Lich and the Timpus are not doing as much as I thought they would. They need to be laying down more harassment and he does miss the 10 on the Luna. Meanwhile, Razor's gaining a bit of pace after he did come out of that lag cave with his ping now. Surprisingly, he actually did go for one level of that armor. I'm not sure why, due to the fact that there is no way that the TA can actually trigger it and would give him that slow against the TA. Even the static, the melt shot and the traps won't actually trigger the unstable current from the Razor. At least some of the bugs are getting fixed. Last game I couldn't click on heroes, but... And we have another discount. Cost 2 bugs for the win, guys. So, anyhow, TA seems doing pretty well for himself. 4 minutes and 20 CS, and... That's all. Is it almost perfect CS? Okay, no, it has to be more to get be perfect. So yeah, anyhow, he is doing pretty well for himself with sitting at 20 CS and the others are following closely behind on 14. And as expected, Luma is not as much and might be a gank on the Chimchar. Is the glimpse really no? But no, the Lich is going to go down and first blood in favor of M. Like I said, if they do get the initiation off on the Lich, they are going to be able to bring down, and there's nothing that the Chimchar is going to be able to do to stop the Lich going down. So much needed kill for TN due to the fact that they were kind of losing their lanes. So yeah, it was much needed kill. Oh, okay, how should I say?
I'm back. Is it better?
Better, much better, I think. Let's see, if it goes back to the normal way, I'll let you know.
Thanks, Tera. I see the...
Okay, I think...
TA is doing quite now it's really well against... Thanks. You know. TA is doing really well against this, Razor. Leading up on the CS and denies on 25-15. Razor's 9-4.
Yeah, well, I still see the Razor actually using his static link and trying to do some harassment on the TA and trying to stop his farm. He hasn't used it at all. He just spam, take the TA out of the lane, which is not going to be working because that refraction is always going to damage, which is going to be dealt from the plasma field.
You can see the Razor moving on to the bounty rune picked up by the bounty. Razor. This top lane is actually doing well, I see. Farming up with the 17 and 4, rather.
Yeah, they did manage to get a blood on the Lich, but there again, he is not getting the same amount of CS that TA and the Ursa is getting, falling a little bit behind. You can see, like, at even though they got the first blood, the doing his job in denying as much farm as possible Luna.
Yes, we can see the Ursa of travel up by the Lich. Luna, Bimo-san is actually doing quite a job on zoning out the two heroes.
You're breaking up again. Is something wrong with the connection or it's a bug in Sorcerer? Because happened to me last game, somewhere down the line, whether it was my connection or whether it was Sorcerer, but yeah, he's there.
Well, not quite sure. Let's start Dota again.
Okay. It comes on and off. For a bit or two, it's okay, and again, it goes. So we have a smoke on the side of the DM, we have the Lion and the Destroyer smoked up, trying to go on this TA. But I don't think they can actually bring down this TA. No, they don't have any vision either, so they might not be able to get him. So yeah, the impel misses completely, so not the best of
Glimpse
work
back.
And the TA will get away. Glimpse back
with
the,
with the face boots
completely there.
Boots with the TA, I think good in the lane. You can see the TA finally down. Takes four heroes out of the map.
Timbersaw top lane goes down as well. Still a good trade. So Timbersaw falls down top lane, and the TA was getting a lot of free farm in the mid lane, also goes down as well. So a bit of a good trade off for DM when they were falling behind farm. Just a note on that. The clockwork, the TA actually had an invis drone, but instead of using that, he decided to meld and just walk away. Not sure what that was all about. I'm pretty sure he forgot that he had an invis drone.
It's just a matter of not being attentive enough, I would say. The game, maybe, I don't know, just
he could have actually walked away, and meanwhile he bottom lane, but
he's
not going to find anything. There's no one here.
I think and the lane cover is almost at quarter's health.
They're going to go on the clockwork, and they might be able to get him.
Go on the clockwork, and he goes down. He just melts to the Ursa's enrage. And the fury and the overpower. Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Radiant structures are. And meanwhile, mid lane Razor is trying to do some sort of damage to this middle tier one, but Guardian is going to be up immediately, and who believes the amount of damage done for the
and
middle
tower?
And that's
the first tier one. Tower. Chero, am I any better?
It is better, but it just on and off. It's fine, man. I'm pretty sure it's a soft one. Fight going down. They are trying to go on the Razor. DB rune is going to be popped, and the Razor is just held here. Held to the DD and the
Arctic Burn. The Arctic Burn and the DD on the TA really doing some huge damage. Razor.
Meanwhile, they might try to go, but the Timbersaw misses his. They are not going to be able to chase down. Good pickoff, a much needed pickoff for team.
Team Z.
Team Z. So yeah, a good pickoff for team. A much needed kill on both Clockwork and the Razor there after getting price on two different lanes.
XP and the gold actually rising, that quick two consecutive kills on the Clockwork and the Razor on either lane.
Yeah, it is. And even except for the net worth, which is in favor of Team Z due to the fact that the highest net worth on, I mean, the highest last year. The Ursa and TA. So it's going to be pretty interesting. I mean, both teams have a pretty good early game. They can handle the early game to mid game pretty well. And Team Z is a team that needs to be dominating early on. Meanwhile, Timbersaw trying to go on this line, gets hexed up. Will get impaled as well. And
Which
might fall
I
down.
Think the fight fall down as well.
Ursa coming in out of nowhere.
Sent back. That's actually very good play by the disruptor. Otherwise, it'd be in a double kill with that lion being such low health.
Yeah. A good pickup for DM. They did manage to get the Lich, the Saw as well, even though they did lose the one, and they got a Ko for Ko and a support on the side. Pickup for DM.
Yeah, and there was a good, really some good rotation need... from all the supports there on the top. The offlaning Quirk seems to be up on top right now.
Meanwhile, Luna is going to get spotted out. Ursa with the blink dagger. Rudy decided to go on, but he does miss the Earth.
With that Eclipse doing some
Eclipse heals off damage, the damage.
That thing. That's a double kill going towards that Luna.
Yeah. Damage on the Ursa from the Eclipse was bit due to the Enrage, but it did maximum damage to top. And the support behind, waiting for Dire to pounce on that kill for the Luna and immediately turning it around in favor of them. So good
Nakaganas,
good work by...
Yeah, that was some good rotations also with the supports playing it well with the kinetic field and the hex on the Ursa, making sure they got kill.
What do you think the Ursa, the Luna will build into? Okay, Luna is going to get slowed down by the trap and they are trying to go on this, but Lion with the impact misses completely. Chimpers are walking in. The Winter's going to be used.
The Winter's
curse
used. Luna. And Luna falls down. That's actually very good, Pico.
Meanwhile, my god, two hits on that Dispersion Melds immediately, and Vader is going to get slowed up into that Chakram and is going to fall down there as well. I'm not sure what they were doing. They lose the Luna, they knew that all four has rotated top and waited there and did pay the price for just sitting around.
I think it was this Disruptor who was just sitting right here. Oh, just walking. Staying right there.
It was actually the Razor who got spotted out due to the mod here. It was spotted out walking up this hill and just standing there.
Both these heroes are the four man rotation onto the top of Team Z. We see all heroes coming back on top.
Thing is, Clockwork needs. Clockwork is trying to farm up his blade mail without actually being in fight top. And Team Z are actually putting the early pressure that we spoke about earlier on. They have a really good early lineup, and with the TA getting a lot of farm early on, he's really strong at the moment.
Yes. I believe.
And they're trying to get
another
Clockwork.
Kill
Clockwork
up
is
on
going
the...
to melt.
Melt. TA with the minus armor and the enrage on the Ursa doing a maximum damage to Clockwork. I don't think he would have survived anyways, even would have played with the cogs.
There was no way. I think he got on a second or so. There's no way that he was survived through that. And TA is. Basically level 11 has maximum he has leveled up his melts as well with refraction. There's a lot of damage being dealt out in with just one hit. We saw previously on top lane as well.
That's a pick off on the Winter Wyvern. Not used static storm, the kind of kill, the hex, everything was used on the support Wyvern.
Not the best of choices. I mean, if you are going to commit that much of ultimates just for one hero, you need to make sure that it's going to be on one of the cores rather than a support Viren.
I agree. This TA and Ursa being really fat. TA with face boots, bot reds, and all, I think building on to it. The Ursa almost done with his actually that blink
Facebook. It's surprising to see though, I haven't gone for the rush. After all these 18 minutes.
I was just about to mention there's a 80 minute game. Vlads and Blink Dagger as well hasn't still made a play for the Roche, and you can actually bring the Roche down fast with a little bit of help from the TA that meld armor minus.
And actually gone with the free swipe overpower, I would say. So, like, rather than going for the level 2 in raid, level 2 under attack.
Meanwhile, the TA jumps in on the Winter's Curse is going to be popped as well. This is going to be a dead razor. Easy kill, easy pick up.
Easy kill. From,
yeah, so glimpse back, but the kind of not going to be catch the TA in time. And this is what I was talking about. The support on
the Ursa bringing down the spot.
Meanwhile, hookshot on the TA, but TA just rips up and Dan fights the clockwork and the, but he's going to.
And that's a very, and that's a dominating streak going towards support disruptor, and that's 1k gold right there.
But Ursa is going on the disruptor as well. Just a lot of early game by Team Z here. What I was talking about, picking up that Ursa early, you need to get those kills, jump in, get those pickoffs, and immediately realizing that all of disruptor on. After killing that TA, jumps in and uses the Fury Swipes to just burn through the Disruptor's HP.
Yeah, the ice armor on the Ursa blinking in, initiating these fights. Really good too, because it slows down all the heroes around him who's actually attacking him. Gives more chance and potential kill by the TA with the slow and the minus armor.
TA blinks in, but misses.
And that's the dead. So I have no words to say about that. We have a pause. We have a DC on the clock.
Ursa just vanished off the face of the earth. TA did miss melt hit, but the Ursa just jumped in and with the enrage and the overpower. The razor off the face of the map.
I think he was like two shotted out of this map.
And Razor surprisingly have gone for a Helm of the Dominator, which I don't agree. I mean, Razor is not going to be standing and right clicking at this moment. What he needs to be doing is tanking up and draining as much damage as he can from either the TA or the. Yes, and with the Helm of the Dominant tank at all, he's not going to be able to do that, because even if he does get the static link off, the TA and the Ursa can stand strong and just right-link him to that before the damage is actually taken out.
Yeah, I agree, because other than going for Helm of Dominant card or a mechanism would have actually helped Dyer's the TA also, him taking up all the damage. Make preferably, because with the twitchy heroes on time of death, Miko on the Dire side, I would say, I'm not quite sure. Team DM, I would, and I'll name them as Team DM.
Yeah, and the other thing is, like, it has forced the Luna to actually build into a drums as well, which is slow down most of the core items that the Luna needs.
Drums should have been picked up on the Razor, and it would have helped much more on the uplifting on the farm on the Luna. And this so just building in, just pushing up on the top lane. Ursa with the invis rune, I think.
He cancels the smoke on three of the heroes. They're trying to go on the TA. He is going to get spread
and
fingered to death. Meanwhile, Ursa is going to come out on the side as well. Static Storm being popped up on top of him on the cogs as well. But Ursa standing strong, fighting. Aegis is going to pop. The
Stopper
goes down with the curse on two heroes. Sorry, Van Hero, the Vader is going to get chased up, but will he go down?
Yes, he will, because the Winter's Curse and the Chakram doing a lot of damage on this Razor and Blink, and that's goodbye for Van.
That's basically a four for two,
I would say, with the Ursa losing
Ages.
Ages.
But still, a very good trade.
Very good trade, I would say. With the, most of the cores being down by Team Z. This Ursa is actually just going to them, saying his blinking in, doing the possible, and letting TA do the.
And we see the TA has picked up his Desolator as well, so these towers are going to melt under his damage. TA has been melting everyone with those melt hits. And now.
Yeah, this is what I was. The tier 2 down. This is what I was talking about. This the Team D having this very squishy lineup with the Luna, Lion, and Disruptor. The armor and the burst. Ursa is actually hurting this game. See, like with and
whoa,
on the Lion.
Lion.
Just disappearing. This ward helping them out with the mission.
But now the thing is that they know that there's a ward here. Lion wouldn't otherwise walk up the hill just for the sake of it, unless it was to pull out the ward. And they are aware that
I think it was the same thing. Yes, I think he has the wards and the sentries with observers and the sentries rather with him. I think he was on the way to the ward, but I don't think that was a good choice going down alone when everyone was missing out of the map.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. They have to be more careful with their movements due to the fact that one hero alone is going to be food for the TA and the Ursa both.
Yes, this like with the TA, with the Deso and the Blinkin Ursa with the Enrage and the overpower. Melting heroes as like we speak, just vanishing them. Supports they're actually being properly wrecked, I would say.
So the hookshot out to the TA get cogged up, but once. Oh my god, the damage!
Oh my, that's the lich. Huge damage on with the lich ultimate.
Good Winter's Curse, and the Razor might go down one hit of bottles up, but
bottles up, but it's
Ursa jumps in out of the with the cleaning up and he just pick up time and after the Razor, which he gets though.
He has picked up Basher also, so that is more potential he would have won if he had one of those Bashers onto the Luna. I would say she would have been nearby as well. That was I don't know whether to say it was a good trade off, but Clockwork,
it was
and
a good trade
Lion
for
Gordon. Yes, with the TA going down with the Curse and the Lich Aldi, all Lich and Winter Wyvern being Winter Wyvern killer.
Clint through the Razor and with one stand and
that is Link as much 224 damage dealt by this Razor.
Meanwhile, she is going to walk in. Is he going to be able to pick up? It's a bad idea going in. He is going to go down here. It's a bad idea.
That's
a
really good
for
Disruptor. Doing much of the hard, and I don't know what this, and that's a free kill with Wyvern as well. I see. So I don't know what they're trying to do here, going in, knowing that they were picked off all the support. Timbersaw being killed around this area, both
I don't know why Winter Wyvern chose to go up the vision. Like knowing that they were dying, he did not have to go up this hill just to put it on. And
true, the thing with that happened there was that go one by one, and after the boss picked off, the TA shouldn't have walked up, and TA going in after that as well, and the Disruptor Ultimate actually having pretty low cooldown, and the Razor having gained a lot of damage from the Ursa. He was actually had around plus 230 damage from the Ursa. Was
yes,
able to just two or three hits.
Yes. Actually, doing a lot of, even with the blade mail on the team, with dealing a lot of damage to the Toa as well. That mech picked up by the Razor, we see. We were talking about.
Oh, finally,
about.
He has decided.
I think that's a very good pickup on item progression wise, because this them to survive in the team fights. Now I think team Z should be actually be thinking on how to deal with this Razor and Luna, and rather than going late game. I don't think they have a good lineup. Nevertheless, what
we
team
have
Z
something
can pull
new
off.
Here. We have have an Agnims pickup on the Luna. Not going for the DPS and deciding to go for magic based image here.
I don't know why Luna decided to do that. It's just the Luna beam free, the scepter duration being and the cast range, I would say, rather than the damage on the Luna Eclipse, just the cooldown and the cast range, I would say.
Basically, the damage does not increase, but it's the number of beams that increases with getting the Agni Scepter, and she's able to cast it on an ally hero as well. You can cast it on say, the Clockwork and the Clockwork with the Luna Eclipse on himself. So, he's okay for prop games,
team
but not incomplete. It doesn't really do much. So meanwhile, Smoked Up, they might be able to pick off this Luna.
They use the Winter Skirt. That's really good.
Jumps in, Luna melts down, and
the static uses, but still the
heroes.
BKB picked up on the Ursa, doing a lot of damage to the, and that's four heroes down to for DM. That's a really good trade-off. With like, there was some hope DM actually pickoffs, but that was just a dream, I would say. That now four for nothing trade-off with Ursa, the BKB, and the smoke gas. Very well for the team. Very well.
Yeah, they did. Smoke up immediately after the Ursa did make the BKB and managed to get the pickup. It looked for a minute that DM had the fight with that four-man static storm, but it was just not enough, because due to the fact that the Ursa actually had the BKB, he was able to stand inside that static storm even with the blade mail on the clockwork and just bike it away on all the seals on the side of DM. Ursa picks up the Roche again.
We see the Ursa being really aggressive the last few fights. And he can afford BKB on top of him and the Basher. I think this item, this is very standard item, I would say, for Ursa. And he's actually doing well for that. 11 and 1 on the NA school. We see the Winter Wyvern up Glimmer Cape.
and
hexed up. He's going to get hexed up by the lion, but yeah, his support behind.
Back up, right back. And
Hookshot Chocolate Limited, Luna Gordon coming with the Eclipse, and that's a lot of spells going to be. It goes down, the Chibital goes down, the Prime goes down. The Lich falls down as well.
That's an Ultra Kill going towards the Lina. Luna.
And meanwhile, Ursa is going to get Static Link up, and he does have the Aegis though. Luna is standing with more than 300 damage at the moment. Is going to be able to man fight here, so no.
So that triple kill so.
Might be an ultra here. One hit, lucky.
Oh my god, he finally TP's out. That I don't know why he was just looking there without. I think it was just the action that enrage doing the work. And the Luna has got an kill over there.
Yeah, they all just walked uphill and walked into the Static Storm and the Eclipse board. The TA caught up inside the Static Storm without a BKB on and Luna ulti coupled with Static Storm with the finger, battery assault. It was just too much to handle without the BKB on. The hero, even though the Lich managed to get off the chain.
Yes, and
even though the Lich managed to get off the chain,
with the Ursa, Lion rather, hexing up the Lich damage, then casting the Chain Frost, and Luna just doing the rest of the work with the Luna Eclipse, just hammering down on those silenced up.
Luna is now going to be building into BKB. I'm not sure whether it is the item to go for in this. Because survivability wise, she has got bombs and the aggressive. And spells wise, they only have the Winter's Curse. Chain Frost, but it can be broken. I mean, the Chain Frost chain can be broken as long as you move away from each other.
Going for an early BKB
without any damage items is always risky.
And that's a quick pop on the trying to reward the wards here. Some good vision here, so know it's ward, they are trying to reward it, they know that they are wrong. There it goes.
So yeah, like I was saying, Luna going for an early BKB without, not an early per se, but going for a BKB without up with some damage is not the best of choices, because as the game goes late, you need those BKB charges to be there, and going for an early BKB but only make sure that you are going to be running low on BKB charges going into that late game.
I agree, having a 5 BKB later on to the game, too much of difference in the team fight.
So they are grouped up in, they might be trying to go high ground here.
The TA has picked up BKB as well. He has a DD rune, but the Ursa has picked up Lincoln Spear. I can see.
Okay, the Lincoln Spear is actually after he jumps in with the BKB. Static Link actually goes through the BKB. But in this case, if he jumps in with the BKB, the Static Link will get popped with the Lincoln.
Trying to do some damage on.
Mina, hook shot goes on. The is going to go out of it. Ursa and the Luna again with the BKB, and Luna falls down immediately. 2 heals on BKB, and nice Winter Curse,
nice and a nice Winter Curse, and Chain Frost, and the Chakram doing some work.
Razor just one hit away, but he does get away easily, so
this is going to be a really good fight by
Rax.
Yes, I would say Rax rather. That's a really well played team fight by Team Z. Taking 3 for now, taking a really good. Dire's top barracks are under attack. Dire's top barracks have fallen. And team and we're on the middle tier 3.
This is going to be 2 lanes of Rax before that. Before the entire team is able to respond to this.
Glyph, Guardian Glyph, never available either, and that's
too push shot on. The TA is going to get combed in, but the
BKB on the
vanishes. Dire's middle barracks. Meanwhile, on the Black Lion, the TA is bringing down the Lion and trying to man fight the Luna, but getting hit by the Tower Lock and will go down here. Bit of greed play from the TA and the Ursa, but they still managed to get the Lion and the Pucker Bolt. Luna pops the BKB.
And that's the
beat throw.
Luna. And that BKB. BKB 8 seconds already. That was just a wasted BKB. And that Clockwork and going in. Death note for him. I'd say desperation onto that because Rax and he just wanted to stall them as much as he could. Radiant's bottom
tower is under attack. Right now, I don't see that GM is going to come back from this. It's a 25,000 net worth lead on side of Radiant and also 20,000 experience lead as well. And they are getting more. They are getting more
and more.
The DD rune picking on Clockwork as
just
well.
Just three-shotting this work. And all of them are grouped up because the team forced to stay in base, holding off the push into the ancient for the best aisle. KB Ursa was glimmered up by the they're pushing on to the Earth. This Ursa, the Luna, and he blinks away. 50. That heck not doing what it's supposed to do with that link up by Ursa. Ursa is the visual lads and blink. I would say that's a 6-slotted Ursa.
Yeah, basically he has no other slots unless to get a BOT into it. Meanwhile, we see the TA bidding into an assault Kubras. Item poke. Why is the side of Dire does not have any impact. They're dying all around, not getting any harm, but they are smoked up trying to find the
smoke.
They go on the ledge.
And the Chain Frost bounce off on one.
But meanwhile, Earth down and they're trying to go on this Luna as well. There's not the Abyssal Blade, I'm not sure why they can't use it. But Luna popping his Eclipse, but a nice Winter Curse from the Winter Vyrim. Razor falls down as well. Meanwhile, they're trying to go on the Luna. Luna one hit away. Luna goes down. Lion goes down as well.
Glimmer came running away, but and that's an ultra kill for the
GG well played call. So good game by
TZ, winning
by. They knew when to win the fight. Exactly when and where, just after the BKB, they pressured exactly at the right moment. There were a bit of miss where they dived too much towers, but in the end coming out on top and going forward in battles.
Yeah,
podium will be moving towards the loser bracket.
Yeah, 41-23 on team DM. They were doing really well with the. They were pressurizing the team very playing off, I would say, for team DM.